But 65 wars, aggressive war, took place without any actions from the United Nations to stop and check these wars. And eight fierce, big wars and victims of these wars amount to millions, made or initiated by the countries who have member states and veto those countries who believe that they would maintain the sovereignty and independence of the peoples. These countries actually use aggressive force against the peoples. We wanted, we believe that these countries will make peace and security in the world and protect the peoples. These countries actually resorted to aggressive wars and hostile wars, and as a matter of fact, they enjoyed the veto that was given to them by themselves and enjoyed the member states of the Security Council. But in the meantime, they actually initiated the war, which amounted to millions of victims.
وليس في هذا الميثاق.
So in this charter, there is nothing that the United Nations will interfere which will be the pure business of the internal affairs. I mean the government. It is the internal affairs of a certain government. No country has the right to interfere in this affair. In the sort of government, whether it is a dictatorial, socialist, capitalist system, or whether it is a reactionary, progressive, this is the responsibility of the society. It is an internal matter of the people concerned of a certain country. Rome, one day the senators of Rome, they gave him the mandate to be a dictator, because at the time it was good for Rome. No one can say to Rome at the time that you gave Caesar this veto. The veto is not mentioned in the charter. If they we joined the United Nations because we thought we are equals, and then there is one country that can object to all the decisions that we make. And it has a member state. And who has given this country this member state? These four countries, they have given themselves member states. The only country that we have voted in this General Assembly is China. China, we have voted to give China a member state in the Security Council. This is was done democratically, but the other member seats was not democratic, was imposed upon us. We should not be accepted by us, and it was a dictatorial procedure that was done against our will. United reform is not the increasing of the member states. It is just to make things worse. I don't know how this will be translated, but if we add more water, it will be more muddy. This is a typical expression. To insult to injury. I mean to make things worse and to make things even worse by how? Because many big countries will be added further to the former big countries that we already have, and like this we'll have it will be outweighed, so we'll have more superpowers. Then we reject having any more seats done in this way. The solution is not in having more seats, and the most dangerous one if we have more superpowers to the already superpowers that we already have. This will crush down the peoples of all small peoples, the third world countries, which now are coming together in what may be called the G100. There are 100 small countries coming together in a forum that is called a member called FOS, Forum of Small States.
Forum of Small States, 100 states, G100.
These countries will be crushed by supercons, because further superpowers, further big countries will be added to already supercons. This door should be closed, and we reject that strongly. And categorically. Then they opened the door to have more seats in the Security Council. This will add more poverty, more injustice, more intention at the world level, and more competition at the level of the Security Council. And then we shall have, there will be high competition between certain countries, between Italy, Germany.
Indonesia,
India, Pakistan, Philippines, the Philippines, Japan,
Brazil,
Nigeria,
Argentina,
Brazil, Nigeria, and Algeria, Libya, Egypt, Congo, South Africa,
Tanzania,
Turkey, Iran, Greece,
Ukraine.
All these countries will ask to have a seat in the Security Council, and like this, we shall have a race or competitions. Then it will be impractical. So what is the solution? The solution is that for the solution presided by the for the General Assembly by Dr. Ali Tareki, which will be abiding resolutions taken by the General Assembly, which will not take in considerations any other quarter. The solution is that we shall close the admission of member states, and we don't have any more member states. This is an item that is provided for the General Assembly, the presided by Dr. Tareki right now. And in place of that will be the achievement of the democracy based on equality between member states. There should be equality between member states, and the transformation of the powers and the mandate of the Security Council to the General Assembly. And the membership will be for the associations, not for the countries. Because if we open the door for more members and more membership for the countries, because this will give the right to any country to have a member seat in country. And the preamble allow that. No country can say to Italy, for instance, you don't have a seat in the Security Council if a seat is given to Germany. Italy Germany, maybe for the argument of Italy, say that it was not Germany was an aggressive country, was a nazist, and was defeated in the Second World War. And if we give India a seat and say this is, then Pakistan both will say that we are a nuclear countries, and we are at war, and then Pakistan, that will be a danger thing. And if we give Japan, then we should give Indonesia, being the biggest Muslim country in the world. And then Turkey and Iran, Ukraine will have the same right. What can we say to them? Argentina, Brazil, Libya that is discarded the WMD program because it will deserve a member state, because it then has done service to world security by discarded this program, and South Africa will do the same, and Tanzania will do the same. All these countries are important, and Ukraine maybe have asked this door should be, this is a falsehood, and this is an exposed trick. And then if we want to reform United Nations, and then we bring more superpowers, more countries, and then we add more to the already big superpowers, which did quite a lot of suffering to us, and then like this, then the solution is to achieve democracy at the level of the General Congress of the world, which is the General Assembly, which is the transformations of the Security Council power to the General Assembly. And the Security Council will be just an instrument to implement the decisions taken by the General Assembly. It will be the Parliament of the world and the Legislative Assembly of the world. And this is democracy, and the Security Council should be responsible to the before the General Assembly, and we should not accept it. These are the legislators of which is the members of the General Assembly, and the resolution should be a binding. It is said that the General Assembly should do and this at the recommendation of the Security Council, the contrary. The Security Council should do this and that according to the rules and the orders of the United Nations. These are the United Nations who are all, including all the members of the world, and not the Security Council, which include only 10 member states. How can we be happy about the world peace and security if the four countries or 10 countries are controlled by the whole world? We are 190 nations and countries, and we are like the Hyde Park. I mean, we just speak and nobody is implementing our decisions. We are just like a decor. You are made like a decor. You are like a Hyde Park. You are worthless, I mean, without any real substance. It's just a corner speaker like the speakers of the Hyde Park corner. No more, no less. You just make a speech and then disappear. These who are you are right now.